everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to learn how to build your very own customer service AI agent, and you don't have to write a single line of code. And best of all, it's completely free to start using. At the Kevin Cookie Company, we get all sorts of customer questions via our website, text or SMS, WhatsApp, Messenger, and sometimes even the phone. Customers have questions about ingredients, placing orders, and sometimes they even want factory tours. Now, I'm usually the one who ends up responding to all of it, and as you can imagine, it takes up a lot of my time. Wouldn't it be great if I could just have AI take care of all of it? Well, now you can, and it's never been easier. I partnered with Jotform to show you how this works, so let's dive in. First, head to the following website. You can go to the link right down here at the bottom of the screen. Once you land on this homepage, click on the button that says Create AI Agent. Again, it's entirely free to set up and also use your AI agent. This brings us to a page where we can start building our AI agent. And the first step is to select a channel. But what exactly is a channel? A channel is where your customers will interact with your AI agent. For example, you want it to be a standalone experience. And over on the right-hand side, we can see a preview of what that looks like. You could link to it from your website, or you could even embed it directly into your site. You can also set up what's called a chatbot. And over on the right-hand side, we can see what that looks like. If you prefer, you can also turn on voice-based interactions. Maybe you want your customers to call on the phone and talk to your agent. Or down here, you have a voice option if, let's say you want customers to talk with your agent directly on your website or within an app. And over here, it also supports platforms like WhatsApp and also Messenger. When you choose an option, don't worry, you're not locked in. Once we set up an AI agent, you can always come back and choose another channel whenever you want. Down at the very bottom, let's check this box that says I have read and accept the program terms and conditions. And right over here, let's click on next. This drops us on a screen where we can now define how we want to start building our agent. And we have a few different options. Over on the left-hand side, we can start from scratch. And in a moment, we'll do this. But let's explore some of the other options first. Over here, we can start with a form. Maybe you want your AI agent to help customers fill out forms. This could be a good option to start with. Over here, we also have templates, and Jotform offers thousands of different AI agent templates that you could start with. Chances are, if you have a scenario that you're trying to solve with an AI agent, Jotform will likely have a template for it. And lastly, you also have the option to clone yourself. This one might be a fun one to try later. I could train it with all of the data from my videos, so if I ever forget any of the content, I could simply ask myself. Over on the left-hand side, let's start from scratch by clicking on this option. We're making good progress. Now we need to describe the agent that we would like to create. Now, right down below, you can simply choose one of these pre-selected options, or you could type in some text. I have something specific in mind, so let me type it in. This AI agent helps customers place orders for cookies, books factory tours, and gets answers to common questions. If it could do all of this, it'll help me save so much time. Down at the very bottom, let's click on Create. Look at that. We now have an AI agent up and running, but we still have a little bit of work to do. In the top left-hand corner, you can see that we're currently in the AI agent builder view. And we have to run through this process before we could publish our agent out to all of our customers and users. First, we need to build it. And this is where we can adjust the style or the design of the agent, essentially the look and feel of the agent. Over here, we can also train it so it knows how to respond to customer questions. And finally, we can publish it. Right down below, we can see a preview of what our agent looks like. And over on the left-hand side, this is currently a preview of the Messenger experience. So here you can jump through all of the different channels to preview what the agent will look like. Let's start by adjusting the design of the standalone channel. On the standalone view, I see a visual of our assistant, and it's a man in a suit. I don't think that's going to work well for a cookie company, so we need to change that. Over on the right-hand side, I see the designer, and currently it's on the gallery view. I can browse through this to see if I could find an avatar that works better, but I see a lot of people in suits, and again, I don't think that'll work that well. Maybe this animal works better, but it's still not quite good. Over here, I could search for different avatars, so if I type in cookies, here I see a whole bunch of different chefs. That might work better. But let's actually click on generate, and let me see if I could just use AI to generate an avatar for our chatbot. So So over here, let's type in maybe a friendly cartoon bear wearing a chef's hat and holding a cookie. That would be perfect. Down below, let's click on generate. And just like that, we now have the new face of customer service at the Kevin Cookie Company. It's Benny the Bear. Now, I could also upload my own avatar, but to be honest, I've taken quite a liking to Benny the Bear, so I think I'll stick with him. Up on top, let's now click into style. Here, we have full control over what this conversation page looks like. Let's select this color scheme that aligns with the brand colors of the Kevin Cookie Company. I could also type in specific color values if I want it to match 100%. Here, I could select the agent title. Instead of just Benny, let's go with Benny the Bear, and he's a customer service specialist. Here too, I could adjust the background. I could even upload a background image. We could tweak the chat style, the button styles, even the layout. And down below, we could even upload a logo into this experience. Why don't we do that? I'll take the logo for the Kevin Cookie Company and let's upload that. Here, I'll click on save. And that now uploads it into this interface. That looks great. I'm feeling pretty good about the conversation page, so let's now take a look at the welcome page. Down at the very bottom, let's switch into that view. Here too, we can fully customize what the welcome page looks like. This is the page that your users or customers will see before they start interacting with the agent. Let's start by modifying the heading. Right over here, I'll select all this text, and let's type in customer service, baked to perfection. We can also type in a description so customers know how they can interact with this agent. Looking over here, these green buttons don't quite fit our color scheme. So right up on top, let's click into button and let's change that button color. I'll click on this, and here too, I could also specify the exact color values that I want, but I think this blue will work good enough. I'll select that. And I think right now this welcome page is looking very nice. I think we're now all done designing the AI agent. And next, I think it's time to train the agent. Right up on top, let's click on train. This is the fun part now. We get to train our agent, and the agent will use all of this information when it responds to customers. Over on the left-hand side, it drops us in the knowledge base view. This is where we could build up the knowledge base of the agent. And we have a few different options. Now right here, I see an option for link. This is where you can type in a website URL, and then it'll use this as part of its knowledge base. I think that's a good place to start, so I'll click on this. Right here, I'll type in the website for the Kevin Cookie Company. We have lots of information on here, including recipes. And I'd love for the agent to be able to use all of this information. I'll type in the URL, and down below, let's click on crawl. Here, I can see all of the pages on our website to crawl. I think this looks good. Down below, let's click on save. It's going to take a little bit of time to collect all of that information from our website. So in the meantime, let's add some more knowledge. Right up here, click on this button. Next, I'd like our agent to know about our cookie prices. That way, if a customer asks a question about how much a set of cookies cost, the agent's able to answer. I have all of that pricing information in an Excel spreadsheet, and here I see an option to upload a file. So let's try that. Here, I'll drag in my Excel spreadsheet that contains all of the cookies and the prices, and down below, it wants to know how the agent should use this document. Well, I want it to use this when customers ask questions about cookie prices. Down below, let's click on save. Look at that, we're just dropping some knowledge. Let's add some more right up on top. Click on this again. Let's now add some text-based information. I'll click on this option. Here, I can paste in information. I'll enter information about our business hours, location, the website address, even our phone number, and then some additional information. Down below, let's click on save. It's such a good feeling to take all that knowledge from my head and to give it to the agent to empower it to answer customer questions. One of my concerns is sometimes customers have a negative experience at the Kevin Cookie Company, and I want to make sure that the agent knows how to handle that. Over on the left-hand side, let's jump into actions. With actions, you can give specific instructions to your agent. So when something happens or some condition is met, the agent takes some specific action. So let's test this out. I'll click on this dropdown, and I'm concerned about customers who have a negative experience. Here in this list, I have all sorts of different options, and I see one for user sentiment is, I'll select that. And now I can define the sentiment. I'm really worried about customers who have a negative experience, or maybe they're upset. I'd like a human customer service specialist to step in rather than having the AI agent handle that situation all on its own. Down below, I can now specify the action. And here too, I have lots of different actions that I can choose from. One of my favorites, you could even show a video, like a YouTube video, maybe mine. That's an option. Here, if I go up, let's have it send an email. I'll select that option. Down below, we can customize the email. Here I see a subject, and I could also type in the email content. I'll enter in, our AI agent is speaking to an upset customer. Please have a human customer service specialist reach out. I think that sounds good. Over here, I could also define the recipients. Here, the sender name and also the recipient email. I'll have it send it to our customer service address. And down below, I can now click on save. Right up on top, I can now review the action that I just created. Sometimes customers reach out and they would like to tour our cookie factory. And of course we offer that, but I would like the agent to be able to book those tours directly on my calendar. Let's jump into tools to see if we could do that. Tools allow you to extend the power of your agent. And here we see a few different examples. Here, we could send data to Google Drive. You could have it display a PDF. We scroll down a little bit more. It could even take photos. It could get consent, find on a website. You could even have it send an API request. That way you could read or write to a database. It is so powerful. If I scroll up just a little bit, here I see an option to set an appointment with Google Calendar. That's what we use to keep track of all the factory tours. I'll click on this. Right up on top, we need to let the agent know what it should use this calendar for. So I'll type in a prompt, set an appointment on this calendar when a customer wants to book a factory tour. And I need their email address and their full name, so I'll make sure that both of these are checked. Right over here, we can also set up the availability. Now, we don't offer factory tours all day, so over here, let's click on edit. This opens up a pane where we can configure the availability. Our tours take an hour, I'll leave it set to 60 minutes. And down below, I can set the intervals. We offer tours from 11 a.m. to noon, and we also have another slot from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. I'll enter those in, and all this now looks good. We also need to integrate or connect with Google Calendar. Over here, let's click on connect. Down at the bottom, let's click on add action. Lastly, let's click on save. Right up on top, I can now see that this tool is running. This might be asking too much, but I would also like customers to be able to place cookie orders using this agent. Over on the left-hand side, let's click into forms. Forms allow you to collect data from customers. Right up on top, let's add a new form. I already created a form using Jotform, so over here in this dropdown, I'll select the cookie order form, and down below, I'll click on add. As we've been building out this agent, a few customer questions have popped in my head that come up frequently, and I want to make sure that the agent knows how to respond to them. Over on the left-hand side, we can also teach the agent simply by chatting with the agent. Let's click on this option. And look at that. It looks like Benny the Bear is looking forward to speaking with me. So let me share some of these questions that I have top of mind. One example, a lot of customers always ask us if we ship cookies around the world. So let me share that back. We also have lots of customers ask whether they can bring young children on factory tours. And of course we do. All ages are welcome. Let me also contribute that information. The beautiful thing here is you could simply chat with your agent and build up the knowledge base of your agent. This is especially good if customers continuously ask you the same question. Simply type it in here and your agent will then know for all future conversations. We're getting really close to finalizing our agent, but before we do that, let's have a quick look at how the agent talks and also acts. Let's click on this option. Within AI persona, here we could adjust the agent's name, its role, the language that it speaks in, the tone of voice. For a cookie company, I think friendly makes the most sense. Down below, you can also adjust the conversation style and how long its response should be. Should it be minimalist or should he be super chatty? I don't know if I like dealing with very chatty customer service representatives, so I think short is a good compromise. Down below, you can also set various chat guidelines. I'm good with all these defaults. Now comes the moment that we've all been waiting for. Up on top, let's click on publish. The publish page makes it really easy to share, embed, and distribute your agent through various channels. Let's say, for example, you just want to share a direct link. Over on the left-hand side, I'll click on this quick share option, and here we can copy a link. Or let's say you want to embed this agent directly into your website. Over on the left-hand side, let's click on embed, and here we see the embed code that you could put right into your website. Or let's say you want to set up a phone agent. I'll click on this. Here you can buy a dedicated phone number for $10 a month, and if you call that number, a customer will get your agent. You could also make a test call using this information down below. And here you have all the different channels that you could choose from, and it'll walk you through how to distribute your agent on those various channels. Let's now test out the agent that we created. Right up on top, I'll click into quick share, and then in the top right, let's click on preview. Why don't we jump into a chat? I'll click on this button. All right, Benny, I need some help. Don't let me down. Down below, let's type in how much are chocolate chip cookies. Let's see if it could answer that. Ooh, look at that, $2 each. That's exactly right. Let's ask about business hours. Let's send that. Looks like it's spot on. Let's try this one. I'd like to schedule a factory tour. Okay, let's see what's available. Ah, so it wants to know what works for me. Let's throw it a curveball and let's say maybe Tuesday at 10 a.m. Ah, look at that, it learned a thing or two. Let's go with 11 a.m. Nice, I will confirm. Once you're all done previewing your agent to review all of the conversations that your customers have with the agent, in the top left-hand corner, let's click on this dropdown by AI Agent Builder. And right here, we'll see an option for conversations. Let's click on that. This opens up all of the different conversations that customers have had with your agent. This is really worthwhile looking through. This may bring up some additional questions that maybe the agent doesn't have information to answer, in which case you can add that to the knowledge base. There you go. That's how easy it is to build your own AI agent with Jotform. Again, feel free to click on the link down below to get started. And until next time, happy automating. And if you have any questions about our cookies, you can now ask one of our agents.